have before us the opportunity to forge for ourselves and for future generations a new world order.
We live in a time of Dajjal, and Dajjal means deceit. The system has been implemented, it's already here. People are living in a world of complete fear. The key of faith is virtually impossible for somebody to enter now. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Reminder was for myself about the interaction of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam and Sayyidina Khidr alayhi salam, and that Nabi Musa alayhi salam took a path in which I will not stop until I reach of this higher reality and the secret of the two rivers where they meet. I want these knowledges, and these are a station in reality that people who want an ascension, why do they go to tariqahs? They want to hear from what they're not hearing. Every masjid you go to the imams, you hear the same thing. So they want some food for their ears, and they want something for the eyes of their heart. They want to see of a reality. They want to reach of a reality, because they know and Allah put within them a yearning that what you see is but an illusion. Is this it? This life of ours, that's all that I'm here for? An agnostic will say, yeah, that's it. Even when we post something about the thing, somebody posted back, that's it, there is nothing in the grave. Oh no, you got a big surprise for you.
As-salamu alaykum, we hope you are enjoying the video inshaAllah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content inshaAllah. Share the video with your friends and loved ones, subscribe to the feeds and donate, every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, and we will return to the program.
Me and you need a physical guide, step by step, step by step. So then you're guided to the turuqs with these three main tests. And we said, Naqshbandiyatul Aliyah, so high that Sayyidina Khidr alayhi salam is in the shajara, is in the chain. So he's directly inspiring these teachings as he taught Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. He came for knowledges. And he is now being taken onto a boat to break the boat. And he's getting angry, why are you breaking the boat? And we said that awliya come into our hearts and begin to describe, why is he getting angry? What is the secret for our lives? What do you care if somebody breaks a boat while you're sitting on it? Because of social pressure. Allah drawing our attention that the difficulty of your submission is social pressure. How am I going to follow these people and what they're going to say about me? How am I going to grow my beard and what they're going to say about me? My relatives, my parents, my people I know, people at work, hey, we know who you were. Why you look like this now? You joined the God squad? See, yeah, Allah inspires. So social pressure stops everyone in their levels of submission. They want to take it to the next level, now I want to start wearing sunnah. Now when you know the key to submission is your ability to control and overcome social pressure, what then shaitan took as a whole path now? Social media. To increase social pressure. He took the one key and made it the whole world. So that if you thought things were difficult before, imagine generations growing now where everything is on 10,000 cameras. You want to grow a beard, there are 10 people photographing you at work, putting it everywhere out. So social dilemma became the entire earth because shaitan knew the key. So I'll make now social pressure so dominant by social media and Facebook and Instagram and Snapchat and every device they have is now horrifically damaging people based on social pressure. They can't walk, talk, move right and left without the fear of what is this social media going to say. And we live in a time of Dajjal, and Dajjal means deceit. And now you live in a world of complete deceit. You're surrounded by what you think are, I have 5,000 friends, me I have 1,000,002 friends on the internet of which I don't know 10 of them. They're not my friends. But shaitan wants you to think, no, they're your friends. I have friends. You know who I am? I got friends. You're lucky in life to have two people that you trusted or one person that you trusted. All is now but an illusion. And based on these friends, I have now an image to upkeep. I say, are you crazy? Have you talked with these people who are image conscious? I know many of them like that. So I have an image to keep, I can't do like that, I can't be seen here, I can't do it. They walk to take a photograph, they eat to take a photograph, they buy clothes just for the purpose of a photograph. If you give them regular shoes, they won't take a picture of it. They say, no, this has to be a specific type of shoe. The 10 other friends have posted that picture of that shoe. So now that little problem is the whole of this dunya. What became little was the ability to have faith now, it was reversed. Instead of the ocean of faith being large and the key of deceit being small that you could overcome, shaitan made the ocean of deceit large and the key of faith virtually impossible for somebody to enter now. How am I going to do it? The whole world's going to know. You go to events now and people are like trying to hide from the cameras, why? Because they thought maybe they can come to do zikr and their families won't know. But they say, no, this shaykh is 1,000,000 people. As soon as he posted the potential of those photos going to, you know, hundreds of thousands of people, people are hiding, thinking they could be something anonymous out of the fear of social media. So then we saw how this key now flipped the whole earth. And this is what they call a Dajjal system. So when people are not saying, no, no, it's not here, it's already here. The system has been implemented, people are living a life of complete deceit, friends that are not their friends. And the more you compromise yourself, the more they'll like you. You watch shows, when they post a picture of themselves regular, nobody likes it other than the religious. You have to take your clothes off to get likes. Now many social media people, they even took their hijab off to get more likes and they entered now the realm of Dajjal. The shaykh, you don't have likes like these other people. Yeah, unless the shaykh has to take his clothes off to get likes, he's not going to get likes. You're going to get 10 likes and that's it because nobody wants knowledges. So you think that those are your friends encouraging you towards badness, or this is Dajjal? And his implementation of his hukum, his government and his way and his complete movement into that already now implemented in China, that your social profile will base on who you are, how you eat and what you can interact with, right? So they'll take your social profile and say, if the collective whole likes you, you can rent an apartment. If you look at your social number, your index, instead of a credit number, which was companies getting together and saying, okay, this is how many loans you have, this is how many outstanding debts you have, they implemented now a social media service. where your score now is not based on your finances but what people think of you and what the government standards. So imagine a day comes when they say, no, you know, beards, we give a down to that. And then all of a sudden everyone you know puts a down mark, your social score drops. You can't rent, you can't buy, you can't travel, you can't do nothing. Because they want to know, why is your score so low? Oh, so you're not like playing with us, huh? You're not playing with us? You're not going to play at all. That's a Dajjal system. So the key for that understanding was, don't care what people think, fear only Allah. You see it's already being implemented, go in. Allah can't get you in because they say go in. Something's already taking place.
With your generous support, we have helped many of the needy around the world. You can make a difference right now by helping us support those who need it the most. Give now at nurmuhammad.com/donate.
So this reality of the boat and the reality of the rizq has to be brought down, the attention of the student has to be gained. They're just running after their rizq and their money, and that running is causing a deceit within them. And their money that they're gaining and the activities that they're doing is holy for shaitan and not for Rahman. And in the end, in the qab, they will have immense regret. When the intention is to be guided, it doesn't matter what your intention is. If Allah's intention for you to be guided on the hadan Allah, we said in Jummah, there's no hadi, there's no guidance unless Allah guides. And when He guides, He sends them to waliyun murshidun. And when they're guided by Allah, the first thing Allah will begin to cut the rizq. He didn't destroy the boat, He sunk the boat. Means that there's a hope that this boat will come back up if everything is done correctly. So that means our rizq is essential in our direction, in our path. And that's why when you give a gift, you say, here's my amanat. My amanat, Shaykh, I'm returning an amanat. Don't think it's from your paycheck that your cleverness got it, it's yours, and that you're kind enough to give a portion back to the charity, but it's an amanat. See how now you can begin to tame your nafs, where the other way your nafs is very happy with you. Oh yeah, share from what we have to these people, and the nafs is like, I'm giving it out to everybody. No, no, remind your nafs, no, no. This is actually what Allah entrusted me with, that every single step was entrusted to me by Allah. And Allah went over everything. When I send you to earth, you're going to have this, you're going to do this. You're going to have this, you're going to do this. You're going to have this, you're going to do this. وَقَالُوا بَلَى. And I said, yes. And Allah described, you're jahulan, you're a completely ignorant creation. I can't imagine you just said this. Insan is jahul, he's ignorant. He doesn't remember the promise he made to Allah and that you're held accountable to that promise. That it's not for you to do what you want to do and live your life the way you want to live your life, your life is not yours. Your life is your Creator's. He created that life, He brought it into existence, and He's taking it back whenever He wants. So then taslim is to understand, this is not mine, this is an amanat and a trust. Those children are not mine to beat them, they're Allah's. You don't do what you want with your children, they're Allah's. Says, I gave those souls in your custody like a shaykh. They're not his students. These are Allah's creation. That Allah says, I'm going to test you and entrust you with them. Let me see what you do and how you guide them. There's no difference between a father and a mother with children. They're not your kids, you do with them, you submerge them, you do any type of thing with them. Your responsibility was a trust from Allah to teach them about their Creator, the one whom owns them, and that they will return back to Him. So our whole life was to teach about that reality and to understand that everything we have is nothing to do with us. And a Muslim and somebody who is in taslim and submission is learning the way of submitting, I am but a servant and whatever Allah has given to me, I'm asking, Ya Rabbi, raise me to the reality of my servanthood in which I'm here to serve. Then Nabi Musa alayhis-salam, he goes to the boy. There's a creation and this child passes away. Nabi Musa alayhis-salam didn't kill anyone, he's just sitting and watching that the child died. But because he sees that he's being taken back. One understanding is that when everyone dies, there's somebody there. Nobody's just going on their own. Malikul Maut and the representatives of the angels of death stand right by that creation. When the moment comes that they're supposed to die, they're there and the soul is pulled. And that person falls, calamity, crushed, whatever the is written for that servant. And Nabi Musa is witnessing that reality, that this servant, when he goes present, Allah's calling the soul back, is back to Allah, the body falls. Tariqah comes to teach that today what the reality of that is maut al-qabl al-maut, where Prophet brings the perfection of all the Prophets, the perfection of the Divinely House which is the qalb al-insan. He's the master of the house of Allah, and comes and teaches that you have to reach a state of death before death. And this child that was naughty and described by Allah as naughty child. These are the levels of the nafs. And if you don't come after this level and you don't go after your nafs, you will be raising a pharaoh. Every child is a cute little cub, right? Every kid is a cub, cub, he's cute, cute. You see these people who like they adopt pets, they get like a little baby lion because they look cute when they're small. But as soon as that lion's 1 year old, he's eating the home and every child in their home, anything they have in their home, that lion is eating it because that's his nature. He's been raised wild. So anyone you raise wild and allow them to be wild, they're going to grow up as a wolf to come to eat you one day. Our nafs, if it's not tamed, not controlled, not under discipline, then we are definitely falling into these sicknesses. So then tariqah comes one to control the rizq and teach the student that your rizq has to go down. You have to understand the purpose of your rizq was not to give only to yourself but was to accomplish your akhirah. Fi dunya hasanat wal akhirah hasanat. Allah's giving you an opportunity to build your paradise home. How? With your dunya. Everything you do and make and serve and give is building your home and paradise. People here think, no, no, I'll do good here and maybe Allah will give me a home there. Well, why don't you start being sharp and buy it from now? Why would you wait to see if Allah's going to give something there? Buy it from now. Everything that you do, Ya Rabbi, all my mawlids, all my practices, all I'm doing, Ya Rabbi, grant me a house near the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. For dunya hasanat, the goodness of my dunya, it becomes a means in which to accomplish my akhirah. So when the time they're now moving to the nafs, then the turuqs and the real turuqs, they must be focusing on this levels of the nafs. And they don't have to teach you the science of each one, just accompany them. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salaamun al mursaleen walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Bi hurmati Muhammad al-Mustafa wa bi siri Surat al-Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Shaykh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Shaykh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide, from feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side, to clothing LA's homeless community, and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. nurmuhammad.com/donate.